even if you don't use distros like Arch Linux, Gentoo, Tumbleweed, or various other rolling releases, you should be thankful that some people do. You have absolutely no idea how many bugs are caught by these distros that are never seen by the time that package makes its way to Debian, Ubuntu, and various other slower releasing projects. Be nice to the beta testers. And this is a prime example of what I mean. All GTK apps are broken in the latest Arch Linux testing branch. This is both GTK 3 and GTK 4 and desktops that use them as well. I would usually have used IRC to contact the Arch Linux testing team to figure out which exact package caused the issue, but due to my IRC client using GTK, I'm currently unable to do that, and due to the severity and emergency of the issue, I'm opening the issue here. A bug like this must not make its way into the regular Arch Linux repos if it's not already too late. I only run Arch Linux with testing repos since I'm an Arch Linux tester. Resulting apps looking like this. This is his IRC client. Clearly, this is unusable. Note though, that some things are still working. These icons are still rendering, UI menus and things like that are still rendering, but all of the text is completely gone. But here is the first problem. The first two replies using the exact same package versions were unable to replicate the issue. So it's something a lot more subtle than just every GTK app is suddenly broken on this latest version. And this makes a lot of sense. It's both GTK 3 and GTK 4. GTK 3 isn't exactly, you know, being heavily developed anymore, so it's got to be something that both of these libraries rely on. This was first reported against the GTK 4 package, but it's actually an issue with the Pango package, so the issue was moved over there instead. Unless you're a GUI developer, Pango isn't a package that most people ever really think about, but it is very, very important for making your Linux system actually work the way you'd expect. Pango is one of the primary packages involved in text rendering, and that would explain exactly why the app is broken like this. Icons are rendering correctly, UI elements like menus are rendering correctly, but all of the text is completely gone. So the app, it's working, but the text, which is the main core function of an IRC client, completely gone. However, knowing it's not a problem in GTK 3 or GTK 4 and instead in Pango doesn't actually solve any problems because, again, people running the same package versions were unable to replicate the problem. So it appears to be with Pango, but it's not every single user. So it's likely something with the data being stored, with something on their system that is in some way connected to Pango. Now, they did find some hope. One person over in the Arch Linux testing IRC was able to reproduce the Pango issue somehow. They don't know how, but now there are two instances of the problem happening, even if everybody else is still unable to do so. So now it's a question of, what is similar between these systems? Is this an NVIDIA on Wayland issue? And no, the person over on IRC has an Intel iGPU. And then there was another person on an Intel iGPU that didn't have any problems. So clearly it's not that. Maybe it could be GPU related, but it seems unlikely. And then a package was spotted that maybe could have been the problem. Mint themes 2.2.2-1. These are the themes used on Linux Mint, and this is just someone installing it on Arch Linux. Anytime you start dealing with third-party themes, if the CSS is wrong, things can go really badly. But again, removing the theme did not solve anything. This is not a win for stop theming my apps. And then some discussion must have happened outside the GitLab because someone posted a solution. Removing home/.cache or just cleaning the font cache with fc-cache-f-v is all that is needed apparently. Running that command fixed all of the issues. Now the question is, Why? So I guess the solution is every time a user logs in, run fc-cache-f-v, and that will solve the problem. This is not the solution. It is a solution. It is a band-aid fix, but for a problem that has never happened before this date and will probably never happen again, maybe it happens, I don't know, very possible, this seems a little overkill. Now, over a decade ago, Arch actually did something along these lines. The problem is it's a cache of your fonts, right? So if you have more fonts installed, regenerating the cache is going to take longer. So if you have 100 fonts, not a big deal. If you're someone that collects fonts, if you do font work, if you do anything involving a lot of fonts, you're just someone who installs a lot of fonts, this is going to add a lot of downtime for basically no benefit. There is a proper solution here that doesn't involve just constantly regenerating the cache. Thanks for the input, everyone. This is clearly not a packaging issue. Ideally, someone needs to come up with a reproducer, then submit it to Upstream. For what it's worth, I can't reproduce it either. With this whole thing being so messy, for somebody that can reproduce it, now it is time to do a git bisect and work out exactly which patch is causing the issue. It's somewhere between 1.54.0 and 1.56.0. And somebody went and found it. Rewrite Pango FC is supported font format. Since we now require font config 2.15, we can use FC font wrapper, which is a much better fit. At the same time, explicitly reject patterns without FC file, since our caching is based on the file name. And this comment basically lays out what is happening here. Font config 2.15 is not correctly invalidating the cache of previous versions, causing the cache of the previous font config version being used as is. Pango started using FC font wrapper as of 1.55.0, which was added in font config 2.15. So I think it is safe to assume the issue is with font config not properly invalidating the cache of the old version, causing the FC font wrapper feature being broken, and with that being broken, the font is not rendering. I think the best is to just make a PR upstream to font config, making recent font config use cache version 10 instead of version 9 to split apart FC font wrapper cache and non-FC font wrapper cache. The idea that FC font wrapper font config has been unnoticed until Pango started using FC font wrapper as a core part seems reasonable to me. If I'm wrong on anything, please feel free to contact me. I'll send the link here to the PR to font config once I or someone else has made it. And here is the link to that PR. Here is the PR itself. Now, it turns out the problem didn't just affect GTK. It's just the most obvious place you're going to spot it. It is also going to affect Electron applications on Electron 29 or older. But as you would know, as someone who uses Electron applications, a lot of Electron developers like to ship really old versions. So, you know, in this one situation, not a big deal. And in the case of Chromium, they just vendor an older version, so it's not a problem for them and won't be for a very long time. Now, Upstream Font Config slightly disagreed on which part of the project was at fault. They didn't think that font config itself was the problem. Adding an object into the font config cache doesn't break compatibility. The problem was the behavior in Pango when FC font wrapper isn't available. And Pango actually does have a patch addressing that problem. In this case, it's just not going to die if the thing is missing. Deal with FC font wrapper more graciously. If the font cache does not contain FC font wrapper values because it was generated by a too old font config, fall back to the old way of sorting out unsupported fonts. And this part right here explains exactly why some users could not replicate the issue. So what was happening here is people had systems that had been around for a while, and for some people, the last time the font config cache was generated was before FC font wrapper was being used. So for those people, no mention of it. But other users, it was generated after that point. If FC Font Wrapper is missing, it breaks. If it's not missing, it works. So it's a very subtle difference in the cache that unless you know how Pango actually works, you would never spot. But that tiny little problem is what caused the issue. Now, being an issue with when the font cache was generated, this is a problem that is naturally going to resolve itself over time. Right now might have been a little bit too early, but in, let's say, a year from now, in 2 years from now, the chance that you haven't regenerated your font cache in that time is very, very low. So there will come a point where every single font cache has FC Font Wrapper in it, and the problem just doesn't really exist then. But for now, having a fallback here probably makes a lot more sense. Now, whilst this patch was available in the Git branch, initially it was thought this wouldn't be available in a tagged version until 1.57.0, and they'd have to go and like cherry pick the patch to make sure this, you know, has actually been addressed. Thankfully though, that's not the case, because nobody really knew when that version was going to be coming out. A version was made, 1.56.1, and in that version, font config handle lack of FC Font Wrapper in font cache. That patch has been addressed. This is why it is very important for a distro to have a testing repo. This is why it is very important for distros like Arch Linux, like Gentoo, like Tumbleweed, and a bunch of others to exist to make sure that things like this actually get used by people before they make their way into stable releases. Be thankful that rolling release users, that beta testers are out there trying things out before they make their way to your system. And if you appreciate these people, let me know down below. So if you appreciate these people, let me know down below. Also, if you like the video, go and like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, sell Liberapay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I think you can tell that I forgot to record the outro.